New tonight, an I-Team 8 investigation that is getting the attention of state lawmakers. A state senator says enough is enough and is calling for the Department of Workforce Development to stop pursuing unemployment over payments. I-Team 8's Richard Essex has the story.
So a lot of this mess is bureaucratic mess within DWD.
State Senator Karen Tallien is calling for the state to stop demanding repayment of legitimate unemployment benefits that were paid out during the pandemic. In an op-ed that she penned over the weekend, she wrote, "Placing this level of financial stress on Hoosier families is unnecessary, as the federal government also gave states the authority to waive those repayments." As a member of the Senate Labor Committee, Senator Tallien has tracked the unemployment crisis from the beginning. She has asked the Department of Workforce Development to provide her with a series of numbers. How many people have received overpayments? How many have asked for waivers? How many have appealed? And how much money is the state asking to be returned? She got her answer this morning.
"We don't have that yet," was updated as of an email this morning.
Yesterday, we asked Governor Holcomb the same questions and got the same answers. "Yesterday, I promised the governor we would deliver more than 1,200 emails you have sent us with DWD complaints and problems. Today, we did."
"The governor is expecting us, so I'm going to go ahead and put everything that we have on a flash drive into this envelope, seal it, go in and drop it off."
"The governor's staff was expecting us, and at least they opened the door for me."
"Thank you."
The envelope was delivered as promised. Senator Tallien told me this morning that the state's unemployment trust fund is well stocked with federal money. She sees no reason for the state to go after money from struggling families, money they no longer have.
"Indiana has put in to the UI trust fund $900 million of federal money. Some of it came from CARES, some of it came from ARP. We have the money to waive those payments."
I-Team 8 has given your emails to the commissioner of the Department of Workforce Development and now to the governor's office. "We have given all the information to the people who can make a decision and can make things change. Now it's up to them to take action." In Indianapolis, Richard Essex, WishTV, WishTV.com, and follow us on Facebook.